So many of you were asking about a decent laptop for around 40k price bracket for both gaming and video editing. So let's see how this Asus Vivobook performs. So hey guys, Himanshu here, back with another video, and let's start. After a lot of research for a decent gaming and editing laptop for ₹40,000, I settled down on this Asus Vivobook R542UQ-DM153 laptop. That was a mouthful. Now let me start with the specifications first. It packs an i5 7th generation processor with 8GB DDR4 RAM, 1TB hard disk, 2GB dedicated NVIDIA GT940X graphic card. The processor is clocked up to 2.5GHz, which can be boosted up to 3.1GHz. The RAM is easily expandable to 24GB if you want to in near future. All other specifications are on your screen right now. Now let me give you an overview of this laptop. The build quality is totally plastic, made up of a decent quality plastic. Back has this kind of non-smooth design. On the left side we get the charging port, Ethernet port, VGA HDMI port, USB 3.1 that is USB Type-C port, 2 USB 3.0 port, and on the right security lock, DVD writer, USB 2.0 port, headphone port, and card reader slot. 4 LED indicators are there for power, battery, hard disk, and airplane on the right to the trackpad. These were all the ports. Talking about the 15.6 inch screen, it is full HD screen which is anti-glare. This means that it is not at all reflective. It is crisp and I'm totally impressed by the screen. For this price, I have no complaints with the screen. I just love it. On the top of it is the webcam which is meh. Companion with the mic and LED. The keyboard they have given here is chiclet one, which is okay. It is not backlit, and as you can expect, the keyboard is just ordinary. I have high hopes with the trackpad as it offers multi gestures, but please keep your expectations real on the price point, I would say. It is okay, not great as MacBook trackpad, but not as bad as other branded laptops on this price bracket. It is just decent. Sonic Master speakers at the bottom are good. I mean, they have a decent bass in it. They are not crisp, but they are loud. Talking about the OS, this comes with Endless OS, which I want to get rid of. So I made a bootable Windows USB with GPT partition scheme so that this laptop can read it. After burning the USB on my second laptop, I took off the USB and inserted it in this Asus laptop. Switched on the laptop and immediately pressed the escape key on the keyboard to go into boot menu. You can also press F8 to go into the boot menu. That will show you your bootable USB device. Now I will select my HP pen drive like this. I will select Windows 10 64-bit version. Now follow these steps to install Windows 10 and make hard disk partition. I'm making 120GB partition for C drive where I'll be installing Windows 10. Rest you can partition however you want. After an hour or so, you can see the windows on this laptop. But before using it, install all the drivers from the given DVD and after that, connect it to internet so that it can automatically update drivers and windows. I have tried installing Fortnite on it and it was installed without any hiccup. Now, I don't know much about games, but in 30fps and 60fps, it was working great. Minor lags here and there, but they were digestible. Likewise, I used Adobe Premiere Pro for video editing and that was also a pretty good experience. Sorry I can't show you the footage here as I accidentally deleted it, but yes, editing experience was near to smooth. You can definitely buy this to edit your videos for YouTube. So if I talk about the overall experience of this laptop, I was fully satisfied for the stuff I was getting on this laptop. The build quality is good, slim design, lightweight as compared to Dell and HP laptops for this price, sufficient number of ports, full HD anti-glare display, around 4 hours of battery backup, good set of speakers, expandable option of RAM to 24GB. I can remove the DVD drive if I want to put SSD in it. I mean, it's a whole package I can expect for ₹40,000. It is future-proof laptop, so yeah, you can definitely pick it up if you need a value for money laptop. That's all for this video.
Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, make sure hit that like button and subscribe to CreatorShed if you haven't. And do follow me on Twitter, Facebook and Instagram. All the links will be in the description below. So see you in my next video. Till then, this is Himanshu signing out.